Okay, it's June 13th, 2019. It's 11:25 a.m. And I'm coming up on the garden out here. There's a few odd end sunflowers I have out here. I got my little bit of a eastern sunflower row or wall or whatever, and I had a couple spare ones that fell off and started growing here. Here I'm letting them grow. These were beans and peas that were planted way too late. You know, they should be planted in the last week of February so that they would be done. They would have been harvested already. But see, these are all bush beans. And you see there's a couple, three pods on a couple of them. That's it, man. Because this is just way too late. This is too hot. Even though it's right now in the 70s. This one too, these are runner beans. This is the Trail of Tears, Cherokee Trail of Tears right here. It'll run, it might even put out a bunch of pods, but nothing like it should. Next year, in the end of February, I put them out here, if we're here. And by the end of May, they'll all be picked already. This is residual garlic from last year. We planted about 140, 150. We got a lot of garlic, you know, too, lots of bulbs. And this is just, we didn't plant this. This is just residual from last year. And we let the grass grow up in here. Next year, if anything, we'll put onion out here. I transplanted a few basil right there. This one looks kind of wilted because the ground over here is kind of, this hasn't been really taken care of, this particular garden. Got pepper plants, one right here, one right there, that's about 10 inches tall, and one in the back there. See right there is a pepper plant. It's just so small. We just put it out here because it was growing. We might as well put them out. That's a tomato plant right there. Small. It's about 4 or 5 inches tall. Real thin. It really shouldn't even be out here, but it is. I put these others in between chicken wire around them. That's about 12 to 13 inches high. That one too. I can't see the viewfinder out here again because of the brightness, but right now there's 1, 2, 3, 4 tomato plants, and then that little one right there, 5 if you want to count that, 5, and another one over here. I don't know if this one's going to make it because it's so small when we put it out here. It shouldn't have been put out, but like I said, we just wanted to get everything out in the garden in the last week. You know, about the 2nd, 3rd, 4th of June. And then over here, these are spaghetti squash. This one was one my wife had built in the, growing in the house. And look at how it spread out. The rest of them were planted from seed out here. And look at how big they are. Every once in a while I try covering the microphone because the winds out here, well, you know the winds. Plus I have purple hull peas. Right here's a purple hull pea plant. That's a purple hull pea plant right there. This is a purple hull pea. See how the spaghetti squash is going into it? I don't have shoes on, otherwise I'd kill a couple of squash bugs I see down there. Okay? But right there, see, that's the spaghetti squash. That's a purple hull pea. Basil, 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 basil. That's the okra. Yeah, of course, it's a Sony, what do you want? Basil right by the turtle. Okra, basil, that's a big basil. See right down there's another one of those spaghetti squash. There should be 4 spaghetti squash on there. Now look at these, how big these are. And that one right there. So you see, oh damn, stepped on for my hand. See, that's about 4 inches. I'm not even gonna touch it though, but so there's 4 spaghetti squash plants out here. And like I said, that one was about 18 to 20 inches long when my wife put it out here. And then look at all the rest of them, they're all growing out here. So this is a residual watermelon. This, we just let this grow. We didn't plant this, but this is a watermelon that came up through the plastic. I need to cut it, I think, because it's like through a hole. Yeah, see, it's through a little hole right there. Let me see my finger. It's like a little hole. I need to cut that so it'll have a little more breathing. But this is just a watermelon that was from last year. We had raccoons and stuff get out here, and there was like seeds all over out here, and I think that might have been what it was from. Okay, then I put this little, what I call my hillbilly fencing. It's tomato stakes with wire fence. I just cut it and just put it through there, just to divide it. But that spaghetti squash going through the fence. Again, I can't see, this is not focusing. It's what you get when you buy a piece of shit, it's a Sony. Another okra plant. Basil. This is a green zucchini, or black beauty zucchini. I cut one off yesterday. That looks like one that's gonna, I don't know if that's even gonna make it. It may not have been pollinated, so that might shrivel up. That's one there, and we have one over here. Purple basil. This is a tomato plant we put out here. See how small it is? That's about 4 inches tall. Real flimsy, and like I said, with the wind out here, you know, if you know anything from my past videos, we do get the wind from hell out here, because we're out in the open. They're harvesting this Monsanto food-like product called winter wheat, and then they're going to plant soybean out here. Okay, so, but like I say, it's open like this all the way around us. So, and we're, other than the house, this is just out in the open. And, you know, I'm not going to, I don't want to interfere with that. I want it as natural as possible. There's a couple of purple basil down there. There's an okra. Basil. That, again, we think that's a watermelon. Or it's either a watermelon, cantaloupe, or a honeydew plant. From last year, or, you know, because last year, see how that looks right there? That was all water, it just overtook all this. Two-thirds of this garden was watermelon and some cantaloupe. And there was a few cucumber. See, that's a cucumber right there. There's two of them I planted there. Should be straight eight cucumber. This is it. Oh, see, I was doing really good with the grass like this here. Taking it, pinching it and breaking it, but I can't do it again with one hand. That's a bean. Over there is two beans. This is two beans. I plant them with these little makeshift fences from the crawling. There's two cucumbers down there. I think those are straight eight cucumber. Basil. Purple basil back there in that little hole. Green basil I transferred over here. Excuse me. Basil. I'm going east right now, so basil I transplanted. See the ground over here? See how it's dry? See in that hole how it's like dried? This side over here, nothing seems to be growing. One year we had some stuff growing over here. Last year it was tomatoes and they didn't do so great. They had a lot of root rot because this ground over here is more clayish. It's still, it said it was a 7.0 in the pH, but they just got root rot on 90% of them. So, my sunflowers on the east wall here, all those spots there, I planted like three times, about 4 days apart, planted sunflower seeds down in here, and watered them down a couple times and nothing. With all the rain we get out here, it floods out here sometimes, so I just try not to water it all the time. So this is the east wall, I call it. And then I left a break here this time. Before we went, I went all the way edge to edge. And then on the north wall here, 30 feet, not even, I'd say about maybe 25 feet back is the Monsanto food-like product where they spray that toxic shit. And some of these are giant. So let me get on the north side of them. Okay, see, I got about a 5-foot swath back here for burying. I put up a fence with pieces of old socks ripped up so that no one accidentally, like they have in the past, come close by here with their tractors and spray their crap. So this is my north wall of sunflowers. See, this is a natural flower. This is kind of like the one of the herbal flowers I got from Heirloom Solutions before. It's a natural herb. I don't think I planted these here, but this is the natural flowers out here. There's a couple of large sunflowers out here that are on the other side of the fence. That right there is either a mammoth or a Titan sunflower that's growing out there. That's another large one. I think that might be a Titan sunflower. But anyway, here's my sunflowers over here. That's peculiar. To me, that's strange looking. That light green in the middle. What the hell that is? That's egg or something on the leaf there and here. That is. I don't know. I'm letting it down there. We'll see what happens. See, here's more of that flower, that wild. It looks like a little daisy. But see, these things. In the wild, there's all types of flowers now that are okay. They're supposed to be, you can use them for medicinal purposes and such. One down there, and there's like one, two, so there's a small area right down there, two, three, four. See how they're all spread out here? I'm letting them grow unless someone else comes by here and cuts them down, which they shouldn't. I purposely have stuff over here so people don't come close. Here's a couple larger sunflowers. That one and the one on the end here are similar, thicker stalks. And this one right here, I think this might be a mammoth. You can see the sunflower head right up on top there. That's about half the size, a third of the size of my hand. That's gonna be a sunflower head. There's just, like I said, those two sunflowers there. Again, all this right here is purpose, folks. It looks like crap, I know it does, but I mean, it's just, for a reason. See how where I cut and I let it go. I could go a little bit about 2 feet north, closer to their field, but I didn't. So, and this is the west wall or west sunflower row. I mixed torch sunflowers in here with these too. Those are the ones with the big yellow orange flowers that the large wing butterflies come out. And I'm not seeing them. I really ain't. I'm getting really aggravated with that too. I got some big ones right here. Another, I think that's a mammoth sunflower. You can just tell by the thickness of the stem compared to the one right there next to it. See, there's these. You can see this. This is a Titan, I think, because of how thick that stem is compared to the ones around it. That's a Titan, and that one there. So I got these spread out over here. Then the walkway before Lucy and CJ's grave. I gotta get down there with shears and cut the grass in between. Elderberries. This has gotta come off that netting I put on there to keep the insects off. It's just not gonna work because look how it's not suffocating them, but how it's keeping them down. Gonna have to at the moment we got that out there. I mean, it's just no way out here. This is a ridiculous area to do this out in the open like this. Open to all this air out here and wind, and mainly wind. So use my mom's old swing frame and put the netting over that. It's just not going to do anything but crush the plant down. So probably this week it's going to rain though. We're going to end up having to take it off and the insects are going to get all over a damn thing. This one here wasn't covered. You see the flowers on here where all your berries are coming out, but See that right there? It's kind of like where insects are going to get to it. See that? See, that's all ate off there. And then south of CJ's grave here is this big mammoth. This would be a mammoth sunflower here. That's about four feet and a half. Yeah, about 4 feet. Just over 4 feet. And there's another one next to it. I've actually had about five or six other seeds down here. These two came up. Isn't that something? So, in about another month, actually should be a major change out here. Unless we, let's just say there'll probably be a good major change out here. So, and over here by the house, we got two tomato plants, two pepper plants, and some basil. That's a green basil and a tomato plant. That's a pepper plant. I don't remember the names. My wife knows them all, but there's a purple basil down there too. You can see that right there. Pepper plant, purple basil right there, green basil, another tomato plant. So we'll see how this stuff grows as it gets out here. And then we got one more where our shed was before the tornado tore it off and threw it into that tree right by the swing. The swing wasn't there, by the way. The shed on an earlier video, you see, was crushed into the tree. The platform is still here. It was screwed into it, actually, too. As you can see by these screws, you see this one right here? Okay, approximately every 12 inches, and then there's one right there because it was a double plate. And every 14 inches all the way around this base are screws that were screwed onto this base. And it ripped it up off this platform, and it overhung approximately 4 feet. You can see from the end of the fence, out of the house to the end of it right there. And it picked this thing up off. That double board right there was the right side of the shed. That was the right side. It was solid up to here with your door over to there, and then, you know, it picked it up off this platform, all north, and then all the way over into that tree up there. It crushed it into that tree, and that's about 35 feet ahead of us. So, this is old dirt. It's compact, but we tried to grind it, to till it. There's a heirloom lettuce. There's a basil, a tomato plant, sunflower, basil, pepper plant, basil, tomato plant, sunflower. So, like I said, we wanted to get it where it was lettuce all the way down this row. We wanted to put spinach in here. But again, with this type of poor soil, that's what it looks like. I mean, it's not great, but it's something, you know. I still might put some lettuce out here in a couple of days before it really rains hard. Where we had the mulch on top trying to keep it down, same thing here. But the winds out here are just like, you know, the winds from hell. All you gotta do is look at the plants, how they're moving around. And this is like a daily thing too. It's not like a little bit here and there, now and then. It's all the time. So it's amazing that all these things are growing as they are. It should be a little bit healthier than this even, but considering the health that I'm in, my wife is in, it's on a 1 to 10, with 10 being great, it's probably about a 7. With considering our health, it's probably an 8. But don't ever, I don't care what anybody says, you don't ever want to live with wide open space like this all the way around you. And the only other human waste icing that there is all this is Monsanto. All this crap around us is Monsanto. 630 acres of Monsanto food-like products that they grow or cultivate or manufacture, because I don't even consider it growing. It comes out of the ground, but it's not the same at all. So anyway, beans and peas, again, if it's not in the ground by the last of February, forget about it. I put them in the middle of April. So, or toward the end of April, which is too late, way too late. But the tomatoes and peppers, 50-50, well, about a 70% chance the tomatoes and peppers are going to make it. They come out pretty good. The spaghetti squash in number three garden back there. Because you got number one garden here, number two garden over there where the peas and beans are, and number three is the long 65 foot by 25 feet or 30 foot garden. West is over here, east is over there, north is that direction, closest to me is south. So, like I said, we've been fortunate that we have this kind of space where we can grow some things. Just health, and now income, because they've just deducting from my disability. Yeah, I don't want to get into it. But trying to survive on disability is like, you know, next step up from dumpster diving. We're trying, at least.